20 years ago, on September 11th, 2001, my daughter Amanda married Ben Brewster, and a very great guy was instantly added to our family. Now they have 5 dynamite kids, and this summer they even moved from Corvallis down to Roseburg, and we just could not be happier about this. Ben received a bachelor's degree in computer science and then a master's degree in computer science with an artificial intelligence focus from Oregon State University. He then started and successfully ran his own IT company for 10 years before selling it, and is now the online program director for the online computer science program for Oregon State. So, when he said that he would like to install the Ethernet system in our house, and would I be okay with that, I was delighted, instantly said, yes, please. And Ben Brewster cemented his position as the world's finest son-in-law.
Okay, so over here we are in the garage, and we are working on the single wire for the network system that we've got placed out here. This particular wire we've made extra long, so it's spooled 3 or 4 times up in a big loop in the wall here, in case somebody wants to do something later to reposition it, so we could move it into either cell within the studs, maybe even a couple of cells, or you could even bring it out, although it's really not designed for that. But if you had some need, you could, because there's a lot of cable in here. And just as a reminder from the previous video, there's a pretty nasty, gnarly kink in this, just from the construction process of pulling it through and the drywall and all the parts. So we'll be cutting off about the 18 inches off the end of this thing because of that particular kink. All right, well, here we are. Months later, we have a finished house, and we have that central location where all of those cables came together. All of those blue cables coming out of the wall here. Well, we've bound them all up, and we've put them all inside this case. The case looks a little industrial. It's designed to hold and protect things. It is either permanent, if this is what the end customer wants, or it's temporary in the sense that it's easy to remove and to put in whatever set of cabinets and desks, whoever the owner is, whatever they want within this room. But for now, this is a great way to protect the infrastructure for the center of that star where all the cables come together. Let's take a look at what's inside it. First of all, you'll note that there's a lot of open space, a lot of airflow. We want to have lots of air motion in here. There isn't anything in here right now that has fans, but you could imagine that somebody wanted to put a device in here that would have fans. So there's got to be lots of airflow. The way it works is that all these cables are back here on this back wall, and they connect to these upper panels. These are called patch panels. And all of these do is provide a convenient place with a set of numbers for those cables to terminate at. The lower device is a switch, a network switch. And what it does is it connects all of those cables together according to the Ethernet and networking standards that our computers and our TVs and everything else these days wants to use. So what we'll do is there are bags of network cables here about a foot long, and each cable can be connected from one of these ports on the patch panel into the switch. All of the individual ports that the user would like to connect are connected down to the switch, and that binds them together. The other major components that'll need to be placed in this case are a router and a modem. There is a single coaxial cable, a cable from the cable company. That particular cable is back here, and what it allows the end user to do is connect to a cable modem. That cable modem then sends out a Ethernet, it has a network connection in it, and that network connection will connect to the router, and that router then defines the network for the house. And that router then connects to the switch, which connects all the rest of the devices to the router, to the modem, and out to the internet. Okay, so as an example, what's a device that we could plug into our network? Well, one thing this house needs, even though it has hardwired network jacks all over it, is we need Wi-Fi. Everybody wants to be on wireless these days. So one of the devices we can plug into this is the Wi-Fi system. So let's go to the pantry in the kitchen where we've hidden a cable where one of our wireless access points will be. Our access point, run down the hallway, following the cables through the house. And inside the closet, right here, is the access point location. There is a small network jack on this device, and we plug it into the cable that's been hidden back here. And this is cable port number 25, and that matches the label on the rack. So this thing has a little mounting ring that screws into the inside wall, and then it clicks into place, and that single wire connects to it, and that provides Wi-Fi for this whole downstairs area. So we have this access point on this side of the house on this lower floor, but we also have one kitty corner on the upstairs floor to provide wireless access to that side of the house and that floor, and that's in the laundry room upstairs. It's important that there are enough wireless access points to provide coverage to all the rooms within the house. So here in the house, we have over two dozen, closer to 30 different jacks through the house. Is it overkill? Maybe, but it's so much easier and cheaper to do it now. This office that we're in right now has six of them in it, and they're spread throughout the room because we don't know where the eventual owner is gonna put their computers. So the more you put in on the front end, the cheaper and easier it is later. There's one in the garage in case there wants to be a different kind of internet connection to the house in the future, or maybe there's a big old fancy networked lathe that's gonna be installed in the garage. There, like I said, there's an access point upstairs in the laundry room. There are upstairs in the TV bonus rooms, in the bedrooms. There's even one in the master bedroom's closet. They're anywhere you can think of because it's so much easier to do now than later.